Dr. Shabir, welcome to Let the Quran Speak.
My pleasure to be on.
Let's talk about Ugur Sahin and Özlem Türeci, a Muslim couple of Turkish descent who have invented a vaccine. And we're really excited about that. The entire world is excited about that. It came a lot faster than anticipated. You know, usually vaccines take several years to be developed, but this one was developed within months.
Yeah, that's right. The malaria vaccine took 5 years to develop. And this is going rapid fire here by the grace of God. We thank God for that. And we thank God for people like Ugur Sahin and his dear wife, Özlem Türeci. I can't be sure about the pronunciation of the names, but
we're
nonetheless.
We're trying our best.
yes. But God knows the names, and great credit goes to them for having developed this vaccine, and it gives us much reason to celebrate, as we anticipate our overcoming the virus, and as Muslims think about what they can do, the Muslims should be inspired by, you know, knowing that some fellow Muslims have been at the helm of this. And that should inspire further developments and research among Muslims, but the world at large.
Mm-hmm. You know, it's interesting that they were immigrant. They were from immigrant families, because sometimes people think of immigrants as a drain on society, right? But here they are contributing not just to their country, Germany, but also to the entire humanity.
Yes, Ugur Sahin himself migrated along with his parents when he was just a child, and his wife is also, you know, the child of immigrant families, as it turns out, they're not a drain on society. In fact, they have now become some of the richest persons in Germany, but the wealth is not so much the issue here. The issue is more that they have made a tremendous contribution to Germany and to the world, it breaks this stereotype of people thinking that immigrants must be necessarily a drain on society. No, immigrants in the first place are welcomed in modern developing societies because immigrants have a lot to contribute, and they do make great contributions. But often these contributions are not recognized because largely the power is retained in the status quo, and those who are writing the histories of their societies are writing it from their own point of view. It's the victor that you know tells us the history. Mm-hmm. Poor immigrants sometimes, you know, they're just starting out. They don't get the chance to be the ones to write that history. But of course, sometimes they make such a breakthrough that it becomes newsworthy, and then the world knows about the contributions that immigrants are making to their new societies.
Mm-hmm. It also, you know, breaks that stereotype that some people have, you know, what are Muslims contributing to the world? Well, Muslims are contributing in so many different ways, but they're not recognized. You know, we see the villains very easily, but not necessarily the heroes. And there are many, many Muslim scientists, many Muslim doctors in the West who are making huge strides that we don't notice or recognize.
Yes, there too, every once in a while, somebody with a Muslim name shows up in, you know, the list of people who have won like a Nobel Prize or something like this. So we have, for example, Abdus Salam in the realm of cosmology. But largely, the developments and the contributions of scientists who happen to be Muslims are less recognized. People feel discriminated against. A doctor may be trying to treat a patient, and the patient may say, well, you know, aren't there any white doctors around, and so on, which could be very hurtful and quite unnecessary, because, you know, the knowledge is knowledge. It, you know, it doesn't go with skin color and immigration status or, you know, country of origin. It goes with whether or not the persons have studied. And of course, whereas it is true that in some parts of the world, the knowledge is not so well developed. But what happens is that people from those parts of the world travel to where the knowledge is developed. They attend universities in the Western democracies. They not only become acculturated to the life and society in these modern democracies, but they also get what they came for, which is that they get the degrees, they have the qualifications, and they're just as qualified, sometimes even more so, than some of their counterparts who may have lighter skin color.
Mm-hmm. And sometimes we think that, you know, religion and science conflict. They can't go along with each other. But in this case, it seems like, you know, it's perfect. You know, it's a perfect mix.
Well, actually, you know, the Islamic faith encourages us to do science because the Quran tells us to use our intellect, which is quite unique in the world of religions. Mm-hmm. Because often we expect that religions are going to tell us just believe and mm-hmm. and you'll be fine. But the Quran is saying no, think. Even the main belief in Islam that there is only one God, the Quran says fa'alam annahu la ilaha. You should know that there is only one God. So it is something that we need to know, not just simply to accept on belief. And the Quran says you should travel and use your intellect. أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ Do they not use their intellect about the people who do not believe? The Quran says, what's wrong with them? Have they not traveled so as to develop that intellect by which they could know God? So it looks like even by traveling, the intellect will be stimulated and developed, and one would through one's vast experience that would be gained largely through travel, would come to understand God and come to belief. So there is much in the Islamic faith to encourage the development of science and technology. And we know that, in fact, in past societies, there were Muslim scientists who made great strides in their societies.
Mm-hmm. You know, Ugur Shaheen and his wife have remained humble despite all of their wealth and all of their contributions and the recognition that they're receiving. And it's really admirable to read their story. They've been compared to the Curry couple. And there are, in fact, very striking similarities between them. So we wish them the best, and you know, we hope that they will maintain that humility and they will continue to make great strides.
Yes, I pray for them as well.
Thank you, Dr. Shabir.
You're welcome.
If you enjoyed this video, click like and subscribe, and please donate to support our work at QuranSpeaks.com.